All right, now, what are the criteria for being a good president? Well, we understand there's vision, there's experience and politics and understanding government, and then there's intelligence, and then ultimately it's whether somebody's good for their time. Because you can have people with a lot of experience that have been in government a long time, have intelligence, but they're wrong, and they don't have the right policies for the time. So it depends on how somebody is for their time more than anything else, because you can get a guy like Truman who had very little education, but he ended up having history on his side because he had an unlucky presidency and he did what needed to be done, like rebuilding Europe. And you understand where Truman ended up with the Korean War, which was just a big unpopular blunder, and especially when China got involved against the U.S. So Truman had one hell of a presidency. And so history gave him more points than the historians at the current time gave him. Now, on the other hand, then you see people, this is where history looks at it differently. Like LBJ and Woodrow Wilson are pretty reasonable leaders, but they both have unique opposites in history, because Woodrow Wilson was a powerful wartime leader and had absolutely disastrous civil rights record. And on the other hand, LBJ had a disastrous wartime record with Vietnam, but he had a great record with civil rights. So those are the yin and yang here. And then you look at people like Clinton and Nixon. They both had extremely high intelligence, but they had massive scandals that brought down their presidencies. And basically, you know, this is where you had somebody like Gerald Ford, who didn't have the most intelligence in the world, but he had reasonable abilities with Congress and government. And so he wasn't a disaster here, and he used his intelligence to the extent that he knew how to use it. He didn't do stupid stuff. He knew his limitations, too, which showed a reasonable amount of intelligence in him, because history has shown Gerald Ford has not been the bad president people made him out to be. He was from an unpopular administration after Nixon had Watergate, and so him and Kissinger resigned, so basically Gerald Ford came in there. And when Gerald Ford came in there, Gerald Ford was not a dangerous president. He was trying to unite the country and doing a reasonable job, but he did not have successes. So he wasn't a failure or a success. He was okay and really goes just slightly below average because he wasn't elected, which shows another thing. So the campaign abilities and the politician abilities and all of that stuff work against politicians because they say whatever somebody wants to hear. And then you got to look at what needs to be done. Are they addressing these issues? And sometimes we may need to get to a third party president or have somebody in a cabinet that's a third party person who can bring up issues that are not being addressed. So basically, then it gets down to problem solving ability and creativity and ability to compromise and all this stuff that truly show who is good for their time and who is trash. And that'll show who can create a new situation that's better than the older one, make the situation better, they can improve stuff, or they can make it worse. And all of these areas of gray in between, because things aren't cut and dry. There's so many shades of gray here. And with presidencies, they could have a good idea, and then they try to act on the idea, but they don't know how to do it right. And then there can be another person that has a bad idea like Nixon, who is not well-intentioned, but he knows how to do stuff reasonably. So he comes down as a decent president in history because of his strong foreign relations, even though he had Watergate and even though he had massive scandals. And even though he ran nasty smear campaigns, he did not go down disastrously in his performance as president. And Jimmy Carter, on the other hand, had a lot of integrity, but he did not have the abilities politically. And so he was almost at the level of a disaster president early on when people were looking at him. But then history sees him as below average because he's had a few accomplishments. So basically, this is where, you know, you see people that have been out of the office for a while and they have their pros and cons. And so the best presidents had a lot of experience with politics. They were good for their time. They had the vision and ability to see into the future. And more importantly, their intelligence was used right. They weren't people procrastinating and screwing around on stuff. And they had experience through politics where they knew how the government worked and they were able to effectively get stuff done, which was something Jimmy Carter couldn't do. And so this is the other thing. And basically, you know, I hope this video works. It helps with politics because it's important to understand these kinds of issues with presidents because they have to compromise, they have to be able to work with a lot of different people, and they have to lead the country in the right direction and be good for their time. And this is the other thing, because historians look at who is good for their time and who is bad and how they do with the laws of history, because we don't know what history is going to do.